Der er mange kunstige navne, man kender, sådan noget, men bekendtskabet til selve produktet, til litteraturen, jamen det har jo en enestående bredde, når det drejer sig om H.C. Andersen.
Ja, vi hørte lige, at han var kommet i fint selskab med blandt andre Lego og Carlsberg, ja. Så det må jo sige at være det ypperste.
Alene, ikke? Og det var blandt andet, altså det var han jo selv bevidst om også, at det var jo den pris, han faktisk måtte betale for at få den karriere, han ville.
Hvordan mener du? Han ville ikke have haft plads til en familie eller en kone?
Nej, han måtte simpelthen fokusere. Hvad var det, han ville? At der så har været måske andre psykologiske årsager til, at han så foretog det valg. Altså.
Jeg vil simpelthen lige starte med at spørge ham, hvad han synes om museet herinde. What do you think about the museum?
Well, I've not had a chance to have a look around yet completely. What I've seen is quite fascinating. And of course, it's a period of history when so much was changing in the world. The biggest, I suppose, start of advancements was the early 19th century. We started the Industrial Revolution and all sorts of new inventions came, and then they snowballed. Unfortunately, we have too many new inventions today, like television.
Then tell me, which fairy tale is your favorite?
Ah, now if I have to read it aloud, then it would be The Princess on the Pea, because that is only one page. But I think probably Little Match Girl. I think that's the most poignant story.
Okay, thank you very much.
You're very welcome.
Thank you.
Thank you.